get an update on the case buildup of the government or the case that the government is preparing against China with regard to the destruction of marine resources and fishing grounds in the West Philippine Sea?
Sige, hati ang sasagot si Bifar at saka ang Coast Guard.
Miss Katrina, ito si Miss Katrina, laging pahirapan sa akin yung mga tanong. Itong tanong na to, I think the proper agency that will respond to this question is the Department of Justice. It's because it's their objective. No? It was their initiative, I mean. So right now, we still don't have an update regarding that possibility of filing a case related to the damages of corals in our seabed. The reason why I whispered something to Sir Nas is because he has other videos to share with you related dito sa Bajo de Masinloc mission na to.
Thank you, Commodore Jay. So just maybe before I share this, another information, just a follow through of the statement I gave you a while ago regarding the importance of the West Philippine Sea in terms of the marine resources. It's just that I said it's not just about the volume of fisheries production, but it's also about the importance of the West Philippine Sea in maintaining the integrity of our marine resources, and. Yung katanungan na may mga bago bang kaso na yun nga nasagot niya ni Commodore Jay na DOJ yan yung sa mga ano natin protest DFA yan, pero mahalaga din maintindihan na doon sa mga protestang pinapadala natin hindi lang ito tungkol doon sa mga harassment, no, tungkol din ito doon sa mga destruction na nangyayari sa West Philippine Sea. At eto nga may bagong impormasyon galing sa aming ground personnel. Maybe the video is not yet available right now, but we can actually send it to you later, no? There's a report na nakapasok yung isa sa mga kasamahan natin sa media, no? Doon sa Bajo de Masinloc coral reefs, at nakita yung kasiraan, yung destruction doon sa loob ng ng lagoon. At sinasabi, according to Filipino fishermen, yung mga Chinese fishermen, if I'm not mistaken, ay gumagamit po ng cyanide as well as yung mga Vietnamese fishers. And according to the statement of our Filipino fishers, they intentionally destroyed Bajo de Masinloc to prevent Filipino fishing boats to fish in the area. So again, these are serious concern that we really need to condemn on the part of the BFAR, because this actually compromises the integrity of the whole marine resources, not only of the Philippines, but including adjoining waters of the other countries. Kasi magkakarugtong po ang ating karagatan. Hindi ibig sabihin po niya na may pagkasira sa Bajo de Masinloc, ay walang epekto yan sa ibang bahagi ng ating karagatan. Umaagos po, no? may interconnectivity ang ating currents. Umaagos yung mga fish larvae natin sa iba't ibang bahagi ng karagatan. At nanggagaling ito doon sa mga critical marine habitats katulad po ng Bajo de Masinloc. So kung nagkakaroon ng pagkasira doon sa Bajo de Masinloc, nakukompromise po nito yung buong integridad ng ating karagatan.
Follow up, just so we can explain it to our viewers, what happens po to the marine resources when cyanide is used?
Pagkagumamit ka ng lason kasi, hindi lang mamamatay yung mga target fish species mo, kundi mamamatay din yung mga fish larvae, yung corals mismo, kasi ang corals po ay buhay po yun, living creatures po yun, yung mga corals, hindi po yun mga bato. So kapag nilason mo yung mga isda, nilason mo din yung mga corals, nilason din mo yung mga similya ng isda doon sa tubig.
Sir, still for the BFAR, you mentioned a while ago that the government will provide larger fishing vessels for fisher folks through, yes, cooperatives po. Magkano po yung budget for this, and is it already included in the 2024 budget?
Yes, it is already included. In fact, we are already we have already started the distribution of our 62 footers, yung mga mas malalaking bangka namin. And maybe this coming first week of April, we're going to have a relaunch of our LIAG WPS in Subic, Zambales. And there we're going to distribute three units of 62 footers. And then sasamahan natin silang mangisda kasama po yung aming malaking, mas malaking barko, yung MV DEBFAR. So upang pong makapangisda sila doon sa West Philippine Sea, but not actually in Bajo de Masinloc, sa ibang area po na kung saan nandoon yung aming fish aggregating device.
Sir, so magkano po for the entire year yung budget?
For the entire year, siguro on an estimate doon sa livelihood interventions, mga nasa 80 million plus pesos. Doon naman po sa additional floating assets na magkakaroon ng BFAR na ibibuild po namin this year, nasa 2 billion pesos po ito. So dalawang multi-mission vessels din ang aming idadagdag plus food boat. So nasa ilalim po ito nung LIAG WPS po ng Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources.
Sir, 62 footers? As in 62?
62 footers po. 62.
Ilang units, sir, ang target for the year?
For the year, I think mga, if I'm not mistaken, mga 10 units. Tapos yung sinasabi kong i-distribute natin doon sa paglulunsad ng LIAG WPS sa Zambales, tatlo yon na i-distribute natin. Doon sa 10, we are yet to verify.
Sir, curious lang, kapag na-confirm natin yung doon sa cyanide fishing, where do we draw the line na masasabi nating attack na yon towards our country? Kasi sir, kung ganun kalaki yung epekto nun sa kabuhayan ng ating bansa at sinasabi nga natin na meron tayong regular rotation doon sa Bajo de Masinloc for the sake of the livelihood of these fishermen, pero ganun naman na indirect yung nagiging atake na hindi nga intimidation sa mga tao, pero yung mismong intentional naman na pagkasira ng kabuhayan nila, where do we draw the line na masasabi nating grave attack ito? And how, or how do we approach this, sir?
Sige, dagdagan natin. Chemical warfare na daw ba?
Yes, sir, Commander. Thank you.
Well, I don't want to use the word attack, no. Masyado namang masyadong matindi na yung word na attack. So we can just focus on the destruction of the marine environment. Whether it's related to their creeping presence sa West Philippine Sea. And then your question is, how do we draw the line? No? Para sa akin, mahirap ma-establish yung drawing the line, whether it's an attack or what. No? I don't know how to respond to this question, but again, for us, in this kind of activity of China, it's only, let's just focus on the destruction of the marine environment. And the destruction of the marine environment is not just an attack to one country's sovereignty. Yes. This is actually a crime against humanity. Yes. The destruction of, you know, decades of years before those corals will be once again revived, it would take so many number of years. And it's not just the Philippines who is going to be affected kapag persistently and constantly they're going to do this in destructing the marine environment in the entire West Philippine Sea and the entire South China Sea. Hindi lang tayo ang tinitira dito. Ang naapektuhan dito ay ang buong mundo. Kaya nga ang sabi ng Department of Justice, we need to document this and to file the right charges against the People's Republic of China about this and then to hold them really liable. This is not just a crime against the Philippine government. This is a crime against humanity.
Thank you. Just to add on, no, yeah, tama si Commodore J, the term attack for me personally is an exaggeration. But this destruction of the coral reef in Bajo de Masinloc is a clear case of illegal, unreported, and unregulated fishing. And if it's verified that indeed the Chinese fishers are using cyanide, this is clear violation. This is a clear case of IUU fishing. And China being, if I'm not mistaken, being a signatory to the UNCLOS, so they're committing a violation because, you know, IUU fishing undermines the sustainability of our water, not only of our waters, but the waters of the whole world.
Okay, sir. Considering yung documentation po na sinasabi natin, are there any, is there any initial number or figures of how much financially yung nakos nitong damage sa atin, China-inflicted or illegal cyanide fishing in our country or in Bajo del Masinloc, sir? Thank you.
I think I have shared that before here in the same platform. The data of BFAR comes from the data of the UP Marine Science Institute, that the destruction of the marine habitats in the West Philippine coast billions of pesos. Nasa literature naman po yan, nasa, ano, you can check na mayroon statement dyan ang UPMSI.